Hello, this is Sunny from My Happy Space. Welcome back at my channel. Today I'm showing you the newest release of Ella Root's new devotional. A while ago she did a Jonah devotional and I had a giveaway with that and I did a few entries in that. So I'll link all the video, the playlist up here for you if you want interested to go and check that out. So her new devotion is Roof and it is available on pre-order from the 15th of October. Unfortunately, just for the South Africans and Namibian people. But before all my American subscribers or people watching just lock out and click off, just stay tuned because I'm going to do an entry and I'm sure it's going to be very beneficial. I'm learning a little bit more about Roof and then I will try to put a few Ella Root's printables which got more or less the same vibe and feel at the end for you, or I'll list it also down below for you which you can go and get it if you feel like you want to do the same entry. So I just want to show you what comes in it. And as I said, then we will do our first entry. So when you get your devotional, it will be packed like that. And it's all the things, beautiful things is in there. Sorry, I've opened already the one. So that's what you'll get. And I love, love the colors, the vintage feel, this Albany plum color. It is so, so beautiful, especially for people who's celebrating fall at the moment. I think it's beautiful fall colors. Love the golden accents and just this Roof. It's beautiful. So this is a devotion. So what she does in the previous devotion, also what she's done is she's just printed the book which we are studying and she printed it off. It almost works like the illustrated faith or the illustrated Bible, which on the one side you've got the chapter or the book of the Bible and on the other side you can do your entries. So basically you can go and do your notes on the line and then you can do your entry. Do your notes on the line, do your entry. So the whole book is printed for you. So that's very nice. It's nice and big letters. So for those who are who struggle seeing, you won't have any trouble with that. And then at the end, it's got loads of spaces for notes. Can make your notes, and then she's got sort of, you won't be able probably to see it, but she's got painted little dots paper there if you want to do bullet journaling. And I love this grit paper. It's absolutely gorgeous. Love it. It's a nice background accent. And then there's just a white piece of paper which you can also use. Oh, and I love, absolutely love this watercoloring images. It's so beautiful to use as backgrounds. Beautiful, beautiful. And then she's got this deep rich burgundy red cardstock. It's a quite good quality cardstock. And then she's got this gold glitter, which is beautiful. I think that will be a fantastic entry to make use of that. And then she's got these absolutely gorgeous girls. Well, however you think Roof might have looked, or if you identify with a girl, just use her. It's all, yeah, everybody's representative here. Love this one. I love it. Also very interesting. It's beautiful, beautiful. I can see like a nice big bold image. I'm quite excited to what I'm gonna do. And then she's got these absolutely stunning, stunning flowers. Her flowers is always gorgeous. Love, love it. And it's nice, you can put it for your circuit cutter. I'm not very good with things like that. I don't even, when people talk about those type of things, I don't really have a clue what they're talking about. But I assume you put it through your circuit cutter and then it will cut for you out where the lines are. So if you don't want to do fussy cutting. And then some statements and Roof. Love the corn fields because obviously Roof plays off and the weeds, picking up the weeds, leftover weeds. And beautiful flowers again. Some more images of the girls. Absolutely stunning. I love this imagery. And then what she's done is she's got an offer letters here at the back, which you can trace. You can put it underneath your Bible or underneath here, whatever you want to do, and you can trace it off and you can make your own bold title. So that is the devotion, or the book where you're going to do the devotion in. So I'll put that aside. And then she's got obviously these beautiful little golden sequins which you can use as accent pieces. I think we all know how that looks. And then she's got this Roof card, which you can just cut out and use also as a statement piece with the background and watercoloring image there at the back. So I'm going to put that aside, otherwise it shines too much on my camera. And then she, as you obviously have a little business card of all the details. And then the main part of the devotion. I think there's Roof. Obviously, it's supposed to be like this. These little things. piece on top of that. You can staple it just to keep it together. And then she goes for the story of Ruth, the difficulties she had, and she encountered. And obviously the famous verse about, I will go where you go, your God will be my God. But I'm sure there's so much more. The whole beautiful story of the Redeemer Kinsman, which Boaz is to Ruth, and how that plays into Jesus being our Kinsman Redeemer, the person who by us. I'm actually studying now and precepts. I'm studying exactly that little bit, the Kinsman Redeemer and the whole history behind it. So I'm going to see if I can incorporate a little bit in my devos or my entry. Love, you can even cut that out and use it. So there's lots to read, and there's just a piece of cardstock, which is sort of textured cardstock here at the back. And then I absolutely love this dictionary, vintage dictionary paper. Love, love, love it. I love vintage. It's beautiful. I can think it can be a fantastic entry. And then you've got this little envelope, which it gives you the instructions how to do. The dotted lines is the folded lines. And it says fold on the dotted lines. And then you just, yeah, and you fold it up. I might use it, and then I'll show you how to do it. But it's fairly self-explanatory. And then you've got your little bow clipping of the different colors. I love these library cards. I've been actually using them quite a bit recently. They're very, very nice and simple to use. And then you get a little bag. I'll just quickly open that. A doily, of course. You cannot do Bible journaling without a doily. I love this little tag with the R on. I've got actually my own tag, so it looks like this also, so that's quite a good idea. I can maybe spell the whole roof out and hang it sort of in my Bible. That's actually a good idea. I think I'm going to do that. And then this you can use also as a bow clippy. Love this rough little material with roof stamped on it. Very, very nice. And then the little wheat leaves, you can even color it, maybe put some paint on it, or put some stamp ink on it just to make it yellow or whatever. You can keep it white. Very nice. And then this interesting raffia, just to give an accent. And then obviously the doily. Yeah, that is what you get in this roof kit. So yeah, I'm going to put you on fast forward, and then we're going to put an entry together. And as I said, I will link some printables which I will think will go well with this devotion. So if you're from America and you want to do it with, and you want to, you can just study, open the Book of Ruth to study it and do some entries in it by using these principles I'm going to suggest at the end. So I hope that you are helpful, and yeah, see you now on another side. I've decided to journal in chapter 3, verse 2, where Naomi talks about Boaz being their kinsman. And I definitely want to concentrate on that bit of the devotion. And I'm going to use the stress oxide ink to create a nice background for myself, because I just wanted to break the white page up. I'm using the smoothing technique, which I just smudge the stress oxide on a clear piece of throwaway paper, and I'm just wet it, and then I'm just creating this interesting background. Absolutely love how that turned out. I actually must use this technique much more. Such an easy way to do it. And then I definitely wanted to use this beautiful girl. I think she looks the most like Ruth. And also obviously the dictionary paper and this beautiful burgundy red paper. And I'm going to sort of just stuck her on there, and I'm going to tear around her. I wanted this organic junk journal type of effect, and I thought that would look better than just cutting around her. And yeah, I love how that turned out. And then I'm definitely going to use the dictionary paper, as I said. I'm going to stuck that on top of there. But I decided to cut that because I was a bit worried that I'm going to tear the dictionary paper. And yeah, I've got dictionary paper in my stash, but not as big as that. So it turns out beautifully. I love how it looks. Love it with the background. And then I'm going to play, obviously, with these elements. Look at these beautiful flowers. I love these flowers. They're absolutely gorgeous. Definitely going to put a flower there in her hair. These elements is so beautiful, and I'm going to put these barley, wheat pieces in her hair, just to almost have an effect of, she went to pick up these wheat during the day and it got stuck in her hair. I don't know where the beautiful flowers comes from, but it's just a beautiful idea of Ruth just being waiting to be rescued. And I'm going to use this raffia behind the flower. There's so many beautiful elements in this kit. I couldn't decide what to use. I needed just to play with everything and almost use everything. I had to hold myself back. So yeah, that is I'm going to do that, and I think it turned out beautifully. So while you watch me do that, I'm going to do the little envelope also in a minute. I'm just going to talk a little bit about Kingsman Redeemer. Now, Kingsman Redeemer was a person who had the right to redeem, to purchase, to buy back a blood relative or family inheritance where it has been lost through debt or death. So this is such a beautiful picture of our situation, that we are waiting for a Kingsman Redeemer to come and redeem us, because we are totally debt in our sin, and we had such a big debt to pay to God, to Jesus. We can never pay for our sins. We can never pay for it, and we need somebody to come and rescue us and come and say, "I will pay for you. I will be your Kingsman Redeemer, and I will purchase you back from your debt you owe me, and from your physical debt to sin. And I'm going to come and make you alive again, give you new hope and a new future." And this is exactly what happened to Naomi and Ruth. They didn't have any future when they came back to Bethlehem. She lost her husband, Naomi. There was no hope for her. She and Ruth made plans the whole time how they're going to redeem themselves. But in the meantime, God was working in the background the whole time. And this is the beautiful story also about God. Doesn't get mentioned too many times, but God is working in the background, trying to rescue and redeem these two ladies from their absolute desperate situation. And it's the same for us, whatever desperate situation we are in. God is working in the background, and He is going to redeem us from the situation one way or another. In His way, and in His timing, and in His purposes, we can just relax and know that He's working in the background to redeem us. And ultimately, He redeemed us from our sin. The biggest problem and the biggest issue we have in our life is the fact that we're separated from God. We need that Kingsman Redeemer to come and rescue us from that. And yeah, I recommend you to read the whole book and just see all the elements of how God is working behind the background, and how Ruth is actually safe, and how she is the great grandma of Jesus. She gave birth to Obed, and then Jesse, and then David, and we know David's the great 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 grandfather of Jesus. That's a beautiful message. Before you get anxious, I said my kinsman redeemer. I had in my mind it's a king, and then realized later, oh no, it's kin, like next of kin. But luckily, I picked it up before I took the photos and I posted this video. I've got some good news. I've got two extra devotions which I'm going to just bless two South African viewers with. I'm just going to choose you randomly. If you're a supporter of my YouTube video, and I've seen you've liked my videos and comment, and I'm just going to bless you with it. And thank you very much for the generosity of Ella Roots. Thank you very much for that. I wish I can send it to my international viewers also, but next time I'll have a giveaway for each one of you guys again. In the meantime, I just want to bless two people with this devotion from South Africa. So I'm going to, as I said, leave some suggestions from Ella Roots printables if you want to recreate this page. There's so many beautiful printables from Ella Roots, or just use what you have in your stash. You don't have to buy anything, but if you want some of these beautiful girls, she's got these type of girls also in her printables. So I'm going to leave it down below in my description box, all the suggestions. So yeah, go and recreate it, or at least go and read the Book of Ruth and just see how God's hand is in this story, and how is how he our Kingsman Redeemer. And remember, for the South Africans and Namibians, this is on pre-order available on the 15th of October. So please be in contact with Ella Roots if you want to pick up this devotion. Thanks for watching. I really appreciate it. Have a great day. Bye-bye.